Oh, everybody, how you doing out there? It's yours truly. You know the deal. You know the name, right? I want to give you a song and dance about that. Anyway, I want to talk about the trial yesterday. I didn't get a chance to yesterday because, you know, I was a little tired. I couldn't be bothered with. So here's the day after the trial, folks. If you want to answer the questions and answers, you can do so. This is the trial, the day after the trial. Now, what I gather, now, you people saw the videos that were shown. It's very explanatory. You put the police officer put a knee to his neck. That was very explanatory there. And one other thing, the trial went on, kept explaining what happened there to the videos. And they did closing arguments. Now, if you've been in a trial incident, a trial in a court system, they do closing arguments. They talk about the closing arguments. And he used the Fifth Amendment. Now, I mentioned this last video. The Fifth Amendment deals with a lot of things. You yourself doesn't have to testify. That's because of the Fifth Amendment. And you have to let the trial play out itself. Essentially, let it play out itself. That's the clause. They call it the clause. That's a federal clause. And, let it go out to the process. And that's what he did. So he kind of invoked his Fifth Amendment right. That's right. You heard me correctly. Fifth Amendment right. The judge asked him if you want to invoke your Fifth Amendment right, and he did. So that means he doesn't have to testify. It's like a circus. It's kind of like a circus trial. They're going to go through the detailing, the witness, but you yourself doesn't have to testify according to the Fifth Amendment. So you don't have to go on the witness stand, as according to what I've heard on the Fifth Amendment. It gives you privileges to, you know, to what you could do on the Fifth Amendment. There's a lot of privileges. It gives you a list of things that the Fifth Amendment comes with. Yeah. And they got a verdict. They did get a verdict, folks. I wasn't kidding. They get a verdict. The judge came right out there, said, do you guys have a verdict? Yes, they do, Your Honor. We have the verdict. And yes, I crossed my fingers. I did cross my fingers, like everybody. I hope we get a non-guilty verdict. That was my idea. It's a 50-50 chance that he was going to get a non-guilty verdict. this is my percentage. So, if anything, he would have got one guilty thing on one of them. Folks, we crossed our fingers, the judge read it out, and yes, 3 guilty pleas. I kid you not. Guilty plea. And everybody was stunned, I was stunned. Yeah, the judge read it out, it was 3 guilty pleas, and you heard as well as everybody else around the world, 3 guilty pleas. And he read it out, the jury said yes in their yes or no answers. And he looked over there, and he asked the jury, said, I'll give you yes or no answers. Is this correct? Guilty plea. And they all said yes. They all said yes. So 3 or a few yeses there. It wasn't looking so good. They got the first guilty plea, the second guilty plea. And I was saying to myself at this point, yikes. This doesn't look good. This doesn't look good for the victim, should we say. One more guilty plea, and he's going right to jail. He got 3 guilty pleas, and the Chauvin guy, I'm not going to say it to you guys, he went to jail. And for apparently what I've heard, 75 years, apparently 75 years, for all those, it all adds up. 75 years is a long time, like you and I, to be in jail. That's a long time for writing a book, to talk a few people. He's probably going to be 90 years old by the time he gets out. He's got 8 weeks, according to the judge said. You heard as well as I did. 8 weeks. We're talking about the trial yesterday. I didn't have time to do this, folks. Just so you know, I'm recording this for the podcast. And I'm going to put it up on my YouTube channel, in case you're asking me. Yeah, I will put it on my YouTube channel. All 3 guilty pleas. I was amazed like you people were. I was amazed. And he was quite stunned himself. 3 guilty pleas. So he goes to deal, and that's it. They showed it. The videos were very explanatory of how the event unfolded. To be honest with you people, they did a little excessively on the George Floyd thing. He was on the ground, they got him in cuffs. I think at that point, I don't think you need to do any more. They got him at the cuffs, as I would keep saying, they got him at the cuffs. He put a knee to George Floyd's neck. He didn't have to do that. They all said it was excessive. I thought it was excessive. I hate to say that. I'm not sure if I'm saying this properly. But yeah, I try to laugh about it in this podcast so you guys understand where I'm coming from when I laugh about it. Like I said, this is only a police officer from the United States. It's from Minnesota. We gotta hold these police accountable. As I keep saying them, I see videos time and time again. We want just transparency. It's all because of First Amendment auditors. Now, if you're wondering what I said there about the First Amendment auditors, these photographers out there are filming the police, getting the story out. They want to hold these people accountable, not just the people in the vehicle, but the police officers as well. So these are just members of the public, get off their cameras and film the police. That's what the intro says, film the police. And that's what, they want to get the news story out there. Not everybody can do this, bear this in mind folks, not everybody can do this, okay? You can pick up a camera and you can say to the other person, this is my First Amendment right to do so, to film. Let's let the other person know that you're filming for the First Amendment right to do so. You have to be on public areas. You have to be on public areas to do filming. And so there you go, folks. So here I am a day after the trial. I was stunned as well as everybody. He's getting put away, and he was put away with handcuffs, by the way, himself. So he's gone for, if the judge will be lenient on it, 75 years from all three counts of guilty. 75 years is a long time for you and I. Before they did the verdict, I was saying to myself, maybe he'll just get the non-guilty verdict. At least get the non-guilty verdict. But no, three guilty pleads, and I was crossing my fingers when he was reading it out. So, I didn't even want to hear about it. I just want to close my ears and not hear about it. So, yeah. But I heard about it, and I wasn't sad about it. I was just sad that George Floyd no longer around. I said a little bit about George Floyd yesterday. Somebody has to communicate to George Floyd in the afterlife. Remember, his soul is still alive, but his body is dead. Remember that. His body, his whole body you see in front of you, it went underground. But his soul lives on for some capacity. Somebody has to tell George Floyd in the afterlife, try to communicate to him in the afterlife, some kind of a device, and let him know that they got the verdict in this lifetime. And somebody has to try and communicate to George Floyd in the afterlife. I call it the afterlife for some reason. Let him know. Try and communicate to George Floyd in the afterlife. Let him know that the guy who put your knee on your neck got three guilty pleas. Just let him know in the afterlife. Try and send that message in the afterlife to George Floyd. Yeah. And someone will have to do this spirit communication type of thing, kind of a device thing. And try to communicate to George Floyd. Let him know that they finally got the guy... all guilty pleas. Just let them know in the afterlife that I may do a spirit communication with one of my devices tonight. And let George Floyd know. I hope he does know in the afterlife. But what I'll do, as a lot of people do with the people who passed away 72 hours, is trying to communicate to them in the afterlife. Now, his body is not there. We all know that. But his spirit lives on. In some capacity. That's what we believe in. Us people who believe in the paranormal and the afterlife should know something like this. George Floyd is all in us, or with us, should we say, in spirit. So that spirit is, we got to communicate to that spirit terms of his voice. He has a voice. His spirit has a voice in the afterlife. So I'm going to try and do that later on. They call it EVP. If you know what the paranormal side of things, what EVP stands for, you'll understand what I'm saying. So it's called voice phenomenal. It's like a disembodied voice. Have you ever heard a disembodied voice? It's sort of like that. So that happens in the afterlife. But you need a device to communicate to the dead in the afterlife. Essentially the disembodied voice in the afterlife. And let George Floyd know that they got the verdict yesterday from a year ago, from your death. Just say to George Floyd, and when you try to get a connection to his afterlife, try to let him know that they got a verdict from him yesterday. Try to do a spirit box session. They call it spirit box session for a reason. Yeah. You're trying to communicate his spirit in the afterlife. Let him know that they got the verdict. And his family is happy. Just let George Floyd know that in the afterlife. And so do that for me. If anybody knows about the paranormal or the afterlife, so-called afterlife, when a person's passed away, you got to give them 72 hours. That's 72 hours what I've heard. 72 hours to communicate to their loved ones in the afterlife. That's the spiritual realm. And just let George Floyd, if you guys have any devices out there that can do it, it's called the Spirit Box communication through apps. You can do it through apps or mobile devices. So it has to be a recording device. They call it a digital recorder, a small digital recorder that attunes into the spirit life and the spirit realm. And if you know what George Floyd sounds like, you can try and communicate to him in the afterlife. Yeah. Through those videos. And let him know that they got a verdict to the police officer that put a knee to your neck. So let him know in the afterlife. I'll try and do that tonight. I'll do it very strongly in the apps. The spirit realm is kind of like tuning into a radio station, in between radio stations. There's it's called empty sound or white noise. They'll call it in the industry white noise. That's the white noise we worry about sometimes. In between two radio stations. They call it white noise or no sound at all. They call it white noise. And that it's like a TV without a cable on it. It's like a first thing, back in the day when you had two TVs, they would have this snowy, they call it snowy without the cable being on. So that's the way it sounds like. That's like if you don't have any cable hooking up to it, they call it the white noise. And realms they call in that realm. And the white noise is what we got to communicate to. There's apps out there that can do that white noise. And these are spirit that long gone, before we pass away, before we're long gone in the world, and that means when we pass away several years, several decades, we want to communicate to our loved ones in the afterlife. There's a so-called spirit communication. They call it so-called spirit communication. That means in the person who passed away, your loved one who passed away, you want to try and communicate in the afterlife. We have special devices to do that, to do so. They call it spirit communication. You can call it whatever you want. But like I said, it's spirit communication. Yeah. And it can be tedious at times. You might not get the right answers coming back from the spirit box. So be well aware that it could be very tedious. But sometimes people can get instant messaging back from these. It's like a tuner. It's like a tuner. You got to tune into the right frequency, the old saying goes. Yeah, you got to tune into the right frequency. It's like a radio station, like you're tuning into a radio station. The same thing as the spirit world. Yes. Yeah. You got to make sure it's clear enough to hear it. And I have a guy on YouTube, and I'll mention his name right here. He goes by the name of Huff Paranormal. You might have heard about him on YouTube. He does a lot of spirit communities. He says there is 100%, this is 100% according to him, 100%, spirit communication with disembodied voices in the afterlife. And these are, I always try and question that sometimes, but you know, it is what it is. He has a spirit box, I forget what it's called for him, but It's a disembodied voice. It's essentially a disembodied voice. It's like if you're in a house by yourself and you hear a voice somewhere, it's like a disembodied voice. Essentially in the spiritual world. Yeah. That's how it sounds like in the spiritual realm. And it may be a lot of voices going on. It's like having a conference call. It's like having a conference call with a lot of people talking all at once. If there's time and opportunity, yes, we try. Yeah, so there you go. So I want to iterate something. So I might tonight, if I'm well in doubt tonight, I'll try and communicate to George Floyd in the afterlife. Remember, it's his spirit that lives on, not his body. His body is laid to rest. They call it the laid to rest. But as people of the world, we can try to connect, as they say, connect to our people in the afterlife who passed on through many devices. I'm not going to mention what they are, what they're capable of doing. But they deem them as spirit box or speed of communication. That's what they're applying. Yeah. Now remember, they're not in their body. They have voice. So your soul has spirit, has energy. Remember, your soul has energy. Once you leave this world, your soul... People who are informed about this should know about this sort of thing. I don't need to get you in great detail with that one. But they have spirit box. These are not demons. Just so you know, these are not demons. There's a God. We start up by saying we come in love. We come in peace. We come in love for the spirits in the afterlife. We come with love. It's like if you were to meet your best friend, we come with love. That's what the spirit feels like in the afterlife. And we come with love. We come with, you know, there's no demons involved. There's just love, you know, love for everybody in the spirit world. Yeah. They're just looking for a person to communicate in the afterlife. And we, the way that we, as humans, could do it through our devices. So mobile devices to our spirit box. They call it spirit boxes. Yeah. And sometimes you might not get the right answers right away, just so you know that. It's like anything in the world. Why am I saying this? Because maybe George Floyd doesn't know that. He's long gone from last year. And the way to try and communicate to him and let him know in the afterlife is through our mobile devices. And I'm going to try and do that tonight, just so you people know that in this podcast. Some way, just remember what he said in this world, in the living world. Just try and communicate through a spirit box. It's not because of demons. There's no demons. We come with love. Remember the speech? You got to let the spirits know that we come with love. It's like anything in the world. They need a voice. They need a voice. They need a device for a voice. Like, If you watch Hop Paranormal, he's got a YouTube channel. That's right, a YouTube channel. He'll tell you what he does. He's got a spirit box, and he tries to communicate to loved ones in the afterlife. Man Moreau, that a lot of you people don't know, Man Moreau died in 1962. One of the YouTubers trying to communicate to Man Moreau. Remember, she's only got a voice. She doesn't have a body, a voice. So that voice is like a, it's like an energy. So Mamoru, she calls it in a different realm. I heard her voice very clear as day, of her own voice. And you can't believe this is years and years before she passed away. Mamoru, which you all know, she was a movie star and a whole bunch of things that made her out to be. She was kind of like on demand kind of woman. She wanted to do films galore, and I never met her, but in 1962, around that time frame, she passed away due to a drug overdose. Yes, in those days, people call them drug overdose. And that's what happens, and Mamoru no longer in the world, but a lot of people have tried to communicate to her in the afterlife. That's right, in the afterlife. And I heard her voice clear as day. It's like you were sitting right beside me. Is clear as day. So Mirro, they tried to ask her a lot of questions in the afterlife. They asked her what is she doing in the afterlife? How's her mental thinking in the afterlife? What does she think about Jesus? And what does she think about heaven? Because remember, she's not in her body. Her voice is speaking. Her soul voice is speaking out through our mobile devices. And they call it the white noise. If you ever heard the terminology white noise, that's what she's trying to do, through white noise. And Mirro, it's like you and me were close to each other, like 5 feet away from us. So that's how Mirro likes to. I was hearing it clear as day. It's like her clear voice from her. And someone tried to communicate to Mirro, remember, her disembodied voice in the afterlife. And she thinks of heaven as a different way. You may just type it up, Mirro, her spirit self in the afterlife. And remember, this woman was in movies, very much a lot of movies in those days, in the 60s, not recently, but in the 60s. She was in high demand. She was a high demand woman, just so you know. Many films later, she'd been to Niagara Falls in the late 60s, close to Canada, a couple times in her films. And you may have seen her in films and stuff, and making those big, huge, major films. But yeah, in life she was a good woman, but when she passed away, there's nobody to talk to her in the afterlife. So we got these devices, so-called devices of today, to do that, to do so, as they would say, to do so. A lot of people call them EVPs. Now, if you don't know what the EVP stands for, short form for voice phenomenal, you know, so on and so forth. And the paranormal people would tell you these things. And so there you go. So they try and communicate, Mirro, I was hearing it clear as day, like her beautiful voice. So she is now in the afterlife. She likes heaven and where she is, and now herself now. But remember, she had a drug overdose in the 60s. Remember, this is Mirro we're speaking of. And 62, this is the year 62. And remember, in those days, they didn't have very much technology to go on. So her voice in the afterlife, there's got to be a way of communicating to Mirro. Well, there is. We have apps nowadays to do this stuff. And they call themselves, it's called spirit communication for a reason. And the afterlife is it's like you're tuning into a radio station. It's the same principle, same idea, same principle. Yeah. And the afterlife is so kind of like that, the disembodied voice. It's like you're tuning into a radio station, and you have to get the right station, like right tuning to it. Right frequency. They call it the right frequency.
And she was a
black female victim of Derek Chauvin. Yeah. So, I'm just asking for the whole world to try and communicate to George Floyd in the afterlife. Let him know that they got the verdict yesterday. Let him know in the afterlife. But remember, his body is laid to rest, but his voice still lives on. Yeah. And there's no demons in the afterlife. Bear this in mind. There's no demons in the afterlife. Yeah.
Within the Minneapolis Police Department, because that culture is still...
So there you go. So there you go. What you hear in the background is a press conference. What you hear in the background. I have it on my podcast here.
Yeah.
So there you go, folks. And I'm hoping for the whole world to try and communicate to George Floyd. Let him know that they got the verdict yesterday. In the afterlife. Just go back to those videos and hear what George... what his voice sound like in those videos.
Justice Department,
yeah.
And the other folks
in position. And hear what his voice sounds like. Maybe you can get an idea what he sounds like in the afterlife. Yeah. And let him know in the afterlife. Remember, his disembodied voice is in the afterlife. With a lot of other spirits out there. So do it through spirit communication, okay? Do it through spirit communication or ghost box. And, so there you go. You got the verdict from yesterday. I couldn't be bothered yesterday to tell you all this, guys. I was a little tired. I couldn't believe it like everybody else. Guilty plead. And, What else can I say today? I want to get off another topic here, guys. We're not here to film the police. I'm not here to film the police. I just hear it on a regular basis on YouTube videos. We're in living in an age of video. Remember that. We're living in an age of video. Whatever technology we have, iPhones, Android devices, whatever constitutes a camera, it has to be recordable camera in your hands. If it records, can it record? Can the camera record to video? It has to record to video, because if we don't record to video, what good is the camera without recording to video? So, it's like, video is kind of like storage capacity. So once you turn on the record button, it's storage capacity. So you gotta store that video somewhere in the storage capacity. Yeah. So it keeps for quite a while. So there you go, folks. I'm quite happy about the verdict. I know a lot of people were stunned. I gotta admit, I was a little tired last night, but I was stunned. I thought he at least got one guilty plea, at least one. And the other rest of them would have been non-guilty verdicts. But no, it was all three of them. It was quite sad. I didn't cry about it. But I know that what coming to him was a stunt to him, I guess. 75 years, according to what I've heard. 75 years, that's a long time to you and I. He's going to be 90 years old by the time he gets out of jail. That's in the future, folks. Just do your calculations, what year that's going to be. So there you go, folks. I'm going to give a shout out to the current president of the United States, the current president, Joe Biden. And I just want you to know that I'm quite happy of everything that has to do with the Joe Biden. Sarah Sanders Huckabee, who you know, was the press secretary for two solid years in the Trump administration. And Sarah Sanders Huckabee, I think that's her name, she was the press secretary woman. In the, she talked to the media people with the Trump administration was saying. It was, she did a good job. I think she got hired by Donald Trump. I'm pretty sure she got hired by Donald Trump. I'm pretty sure. There was a little story there that she got hired by Donald Trump. But anyway, that's no here, no there. I guess she can tell by her story. She got a big applause of her. She was in an arena when Donald Trump was doing his press conference, and Sarah Sanders happened to be so-called Sarah Sanders happened to be there, and the crowd was really cheering for her. And she got a big smile out of it because the crowd was cheering for her, and she was at the podium where Donald Trump was at one of these rallies. And Sarah Sanders, who was the same age as Heather Sweeney, one of my mom's brother's daughters. I don't know what they call her. Apparently she wants to be called Sarah Sanders Huckabee. You know the deal, folks. She's the same age as Heather Sweeney. Yeah. Exact same age as her. So, folks, but Joe Biden, he's doing a good job. He's doing a good job. But not a lot of people do like Joe Biden, but he's trying to do good in the world. And remember, he's the current president of the United States until the year 2024. Just remember that. So there you go, folks. Here in Canada, we get Justin Trudeau. He's the Right Honor Justin Trudeau. That's what he wants to be called. And he's the liberal guy. He's so-called liberal. Remember, he's the liberal leader. Yeah. And he speaks English and French language is very good. So he can say it in French or he can say it in English. So if you guys know how to speak French, this will be easy for you guys. Yeah. So Justin Trudeau, he's a liberal guy. He's the Right Honor. They like to call him the Right Honor Justin Trudeau. That's what the parliament like to say to him. Yeah. And so, yeah. And the conservative leader, he's the opposite of Justin Trudeau on the other side of the floor. He's the conservative guy, conservative party leader. And he's O'Toole. I think his name is O'Toole. And he's the opposite to Justin Trudeau. So he's the other side of Justin Trudeau. And And I like politicians as much as the other person does. They're trying to do out there. They're the leaders of this world. They're the leaders that are going to lead this world to be great and better than it's always been. And they like to talk about climate change. Now, I changed my outlook on climate change for a few years, for many reasons. And reefs. You ever heard of the reefs? The so-called reefs. That's the part of the climate change. The sea reefs. Yeah. And I want to give some name recognition to Joe Biden. I think he's doing a good job. I think he really is. And that's my view on it. And Donald Trump, I think I liked him a bit, just a bit here and there. But Joe Biden, I don't know. I really don't know. But what else can I say? Oh, don't forget. This world has been great. There's a lot of things I can say about the world. We're living in the end times. If you're wondering, if everybody's saying we're living in the end times, I totally agree. We're living in end times. And is there going to be a war? Nope. There's not going to be any wars coming up. Mark my word, there's not going to be like any wars whatsoever. We had World War I, World War II in the 40s. If you ever grew up those years, yes, we did have wars in those years. World War II, they gave up, they put up the white flag. Yes, they put the white flag and went home. They went home. They gave up the war and went home. Yeah, and the war ends. Essentially, the war ends, and waved the white flag, and everybody went home. And that's it. So, what else can I say that might be interesting to you guys out there? I'm just laughing about a lot of people sometimes. I like YouTubers out there. I like YouTube. They're quite humorous. They're quite, I learned a lot about their YouTube channels, and they call YouTube users or YouTube community users. They have YouTube channels, and they really do, far and wide. And I always tell people, whatever you want to do with your YouTube channel, be my guest. That's your YouTube channel. Whatever content you want to put out, it's your YouTube channel. So be my guest, knock yourself out kind of thing. So remember, to start a YouTube channel, it's very simple. You have to be a certain age to start up a YouTube channel. And you don't need your parents' permission to upload videos. And just remember, bear this in mind, you can have a public video or a private video or unlisted video. Unlisted means won't be indexed. Yeah. Or you can schedule it to be coming on at a different time or a different date. So there you go. There's your fourth option. So it's all in the settings section of YouTube. And you know, by the way, in the private setting, you can send it by email. You can send it by email in a private video. And So I said what I need to say. George Floyd's no longer in the world. I'll try to communicate to George Floyd later on tonight. I'll do my 100% darndest to communicate to him in the afterlife. His voice has his body has energy. That energy still resonates in the afterlife. And I'll try and communicate to him spirit box. I'll try and communicate to him and let him know that the three guilty pleas happened yesterday. And his family is very happy. I'll let him know that his family is very much happy.
That has occurred not just in one.
And I heard about his family yesterday, one of those videos yesterday, and I'm sort of trying to think of what to say here that could make sense for everybody. And, so I'll try my darnest, my 100% darnest to communicate to George Floyd through Ghost apps. And the paranormal apps. And it's called they're called spirit apps in the afterlife. We'll come with love. We come with love. All spirits in the afterlife will come with love. So we let the spirits know we come with love. We don't come with hate. We come with love.
Real time?
Yeah.
It's digital?
They need a voice. They need a voice on this side, the living, not the dead. They need a voice from the living to make their voice known. The people that are dead already underground, that's not due to pandemic, that's due to many other reasons. So there you go, folks. We'll try and communicate to George Floyd. I'll do my darndest to do it. I think I know what his voice sounds like in terms of what he was in the living.
He just from a fake $20 bill.
I mean, I was saying to myself last night, a fake $20 bill? I mean, really? I mean, come on. People really get real with me. Yeah. So anyway, this is all stems because of a fake $20 bill. I mean, that's stupid. I mean, you and I could go to a store with a fake $20 bill and they get police after us. Anyway, never mind. George Floyd shouldn't die, really. I mean, all seriousness, I thought one of the videos I saw, even before last year, I think, I don't know if it was due to the drugs that he was on, I don't know if it was so many factors, I really don't know. I didn't know the guy until they showed the videos on YouTube videos, the viral videos. I'm pretty happy about that, and all lives matter, by the way. Don't forget, all lives matter, not black lives matter. All people, that's Native people, that's also Native people, Native Indians people, that's all people. Black Lives Matter always means black people only. No, it should mean all people. But black people get the short end of the stick, if you're wondering. They really do in a society. Short end of the stick because due to police being around and a whole bunch of things. So let me, I'm not speaking for everybody. Just so you know, I'm not speaking for everybody. That's up to them to say what they want to say. You know, it's like, I'll give them voice what they need to say. Like, I'll let them speak on and say what they need to say. I won't say anything for them. You know, they want to speak out of an authority voice, so I'll give them a chance to do that. So there you go. So there you go, folks. I'm very happy with a lot of people out there, Native or white people or black people, no matter what, or Asian people, demographic. They call it demographic. And, I like every people. It doesn't matter if they're black, Asian, Native, you know, those kind of people, Native people. And, remember, we come from different backgrounds, different lifestyles, different voices, to different languages. Remember, different languages. Can you believe this? Different languages. Not just the English language, just many languages besides English language. Yeah, we're supposed to be fluent in many languages, including French, by the way, because Quebec is French-related. That's in Canada, Ontario. They speak in a French language. So you got to know the French language very well. Politarians know the French language. Yeah, they like to say it either in an English sense or a French language sense. So you can understand the French language. Now, they don't do it all the time. They kind of do off and on. So, yeah. So, there you go, folks. I told you what the verdict is. I wish that I'd like everybody else. I don't know. But, yeah, it is what it is. I keep saying to these people, it is what it is. 75 years, that guy's going to be gone, according to what I've heard. It's a long time. 90 years old. Now, I didn't look up his name. But according to what I saw, when I saw at the trial, he looked pretty much young at that certain age. So I'm assuming he'll be out of jail by the time 90 years old. So he'll be an old man by the time he gets out.
Yeah, I'm Eddie Brown, I'm the Clements County Judge.
And that's terms of age. Remember, age does make a difference. Okay, my friend always keeps saying, you know, it's not an age thing. Well, it really is. Yeah. See. Now, I'm just learning the amendments to your constitution and the HIPAA laws. They call it the HIPAA laws. Remember that HIPAA law thing? Well, that's the HIPAA laws.
They basically create unnecessary red
tape. So, yeah. And there's a lot of laws in the United States. I can't keep up with them. But just recently, they used the Fifth Amendment. They used the Fifth Amendment. And the First Amendment as well is now going to be widely used now. Yeah. The Fifth Amendment allows you to not testify your own oneself, as they would say, or your own self or oneself. You don't have to testify at the witness stands. And that also, there's plenty to the Fifth Amendment, just the law. Apparently there's about five of them. The Fifth Amendment allows you to, that's apparently a federal clause. That's a federal clause where it plays out. And the judge will give you those privileges to use the Fifth Amendment. And if it's a yes or no answer, you can go on a witness stand, or you don't have to on the Fifth Amendment. Yeah. So he kind of evoked that Fifth Amendment, and he used it. So that I just heard that recently, by the way, folks. I just heard that recently. So I had to do the tutorial one of the 101 tutorial on what Fifth Amendment really means, what that entails. So it gives you like a long list of what the Fifth Amendment really means in a definition kind of way. Yeah. So there you go, folks. I'm surprised it's not well used. It's only used in the United States, U.S. citizens. Not to Canadians. They can't use that Fifth Amendment in the Canadians. We have the charter rights. Here in Canada, we have the charter rights. It's not like the Americans. We have the charter rights. If you ever come to live in Canada, we have the charter rights.
Without the right to vote, our democracy is mostly government.
So I haven't read up on the charter rights, knowing that I live in Canada. Unless you hear on YouTube videos.
And tell them that you oppose
so, yeah, if you're a Canadian, so-called Canadian, you live in Canada, you can have a different... you can have different passports if you live in the United States. And if you travel from the United States and come into Canada, you may know the Canadian laws. So there you go. And I want to talk a little bit about Doug Ford. Now, a lot of you people have heard about Doug Ford ever since day one. That's day one before the pandemic even started. He's been there ever since. And he's been telling people about the vaccines. he's been advocating about this. Yeah, and he's got the right people to be there. He's got the Minister of Education. That's the Minister of Education who's been pointed to. That's the guy who talks about the education front. To schools being open, to teachers teaching, how many kids are allowed to be in the classes. So he speaks of the union of the teachers.
And I'm going to speak truth to power.
Yeah. So you get your, if you want to talk about the education front, he's the guy you want to talk about with your education front.
I stand on the shoulders of those.
He's a government guy who is the Minister of Education. That's what the title is. And the health people, who you talk about sometimes, the health people, we got the Chief of Health talking about the health of Ontarians. And... Yeah, and we get updates, I think, you know what, in all seriousness, I kind of like Doug Ford a little bit. It tells it like a humorous kind of way. It says, guys, we got to get it going kind of thing. Yeah. So, he's the Premier of Ontario. He's the Premier of Ontario. Remember that. Premier of Ontario is Doug Ford. Yeah. Yeah. And he's the Premier of Ontario because he's at Queen's Park here in Ontario. And he's the Premier. He's not the Justin Trudeau's of the world. Yeah. And Justin Trudeau's your liberal guy. Remember that. If you come into Canada, if you want to know who your liberal guy is, it's Justin Trudeau. That's your liberal guy. He's the Prime Minister of Canada, as far as I know. And the Conservative guy, the Conservative Party leader, is O'Toole, apparently what I've heard. He's the opposite to Justin Trudeau.
Jim Crow in this country.
Yeah. And, so I'm going to leave it at that. I'm sorry I'm going for very long. I'm going to go 44 minutes of this. And I'm going to leave you with a final thought. That's right, a final thought. Be nice to your neighbors, be nice to everybody out there, and we're going to get through this, just like Doug Ford would say. We're going to get through this. And yes, together we'll get through this. And the vaccines, yes, do your vaccines. I'm not going to do my vaccines because I have my reasons. But you people out there, do your vaccines. I've heard horror stories about vaccines lately, but I'm not going to do any vaccines unless it's a flu vaccine. I know even that's a bit iffy. But everybody out there, if you want to do your vaccine, you have the duty to do that if you want to. And it's free vaccines, free vaccines. The health, you don't have to pay for health care for that. And what else can I say? One other thing. I lost my best friend of 32 years, and my real dad passed away 2 months ago, or close to 2 months. And it's very sad in my family. Two people in my life passed away. My best friend, 2018, and then this year, my dad. So it's sad. My friend was kind of like my rock star in my world. He was kind of like my rock star in my world. And he did the victory speech. I like that. He did the victory speech to everybody. And he did it really good. He did it really good. He's got motivation. The word I would use with a lot of people is motivation. You got to have motivation. You got to have motivation. Be motivated by yourself. Yeah. And what could you do? Be motivated. Well, you can do many things to be motivated. You know, you just need the motivation to do it. Yeah, so there you go, folks. He was kind of like my famous friend I never had. That was Thunder Nabs, kind of like me. It was just a friendship, just a whole entire friendship. For 32 years. Remember, it's 32 years of friendship. That's a long time. And I've seen everything in this world. Everything. He had girlfriends. I had girlfriends. Remember, we're not married. We have girlfriends, but we never got married to a lovely girlfriend, so-called girlfriends. We were about to, but he passed away before he could marry someone. But it was a little bit sad, He had two girlfriends, not just one girlfriend, two girlfriends. So I would say he was a lucky guy. But he loved both of the girlfriends that he was with. One was the same age, one was a much younger age. So, and he loved both of them. Remember, they were just two girlfriends that he appreciated. Yeah. Chrissy was, she was the kind of girlfriend you always wanted in your world. She was, because I saw it firsthand, just so you know. I saw it firsthand with my own eyes. I think Chrissy was pretty good. She was all in the moment. Yes, if you're wondering. Yeah, she was all in the moment. And my friend now, I really appreciate it. He really did. He was quite happy about Chrissy. And the story went, you should laugh about this, folks. He met her when she was in diapers. And I said to myself, no, it can't be. That was a humorous joke. I thought it was a humorous joke that he said to his girlfriend. But no, probably when Chrissy was around, 15 years old maybe? So, like I said, it was a running joke. It was kind of like a running joke. Yeah. But yeah, he appreciated her a lot, really a lot, and I saw it firsthand. Not all the time, but remember this, not all the time with her. But just sometimes when I see both of them, I think they're a pretty good couple. They're a really good couple for each other. And we're all better than this. We're all better than this in terms of relationships and friendships. We're better than this, and we really are. And we all have girlfriends and boyfriends. We're all in this together kind of thing. You know, our relationships have got to be stronger, not weaker. Stronger. Yeah, it's always good to have a girlfriend in your life that you appreciate. I call it the soulmate. You got to have a soulmate in your life. Some girlfriend you appreciate in your own world. Yeah. Someone you can adapt to for a long period of time, not a short period of time. Yeah, have a long relationship. They call it the longevity Yeah. It could be a wife, a girlfriend, or a middle-aged girlfriend you can appreciate. So, really hard to have a relationship, folks. It really is hard to have a relationship. It's a work at it. They call it the work at it in relationship with two couples. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to leave it at that. I'm glad I said my piece, this is a podcast, by the way, in case you're wondering. This is a podcast, not a rant. Nope, it's not a rant. And I'm not like Alex Jones. I'm not the guy on InfoWars. I want to give a shout out to all my YouTubers out there. I do describe a whole bunch of them out there. I'm not going to give names. I'm not giving name recognition out there. They know who they are, right? Right? So I want to. I'm just doing my own thing on my YouTube channel, and I'm just one person only out there. It's like a voice in a wilderness kind of thing. So I want to get my voice out there. I want to be heard just like the rest of the YouTubers out there. I want to make myself well known, and I want to get my subscriber base. I want to get my viewership. I want to get my sharing out there. I want you guys to share the videos of mine if you want to, and you can hear what I have to say. And remember, these are production videos. These are production videos, remember, to begin and end. Yeah. So I have intros and outros on the videos. So it's production videos. They call them production videos. And I want to say to everybody out there, oh, by the way, I like Kelly Clarkson. I like Kelly Clarkson. I almost forgot about her. She does a TV show. I like her a bit. And this other lady who was on the TV show for quite a while, you might have heard about her. She's been on that E.T. film. Forget her name. Drew Barrymore. You might have heard. She's an actor. And now has a talk show now. Very much a talk show. Drew Barrymore, she was in a lot of films from the early 80s onward. Now she has a TV show now. She's a lot older now, not younger, but older in terms of age. I can look at her by her face, just by her face. So there you go, folks. Drew Barrymore, which you all know, she was an actor. Yes, an actor. Her father was an actor. A lot of people didn't know that. From way back in the 40s and 50s, her father was an actor as well. I've heard this story many times told. From her. So, there you go, folks. You heard it from me. Drew Barrymore had a father who was an actor in the movie industry. This is way back in the 40s. She told this publicly a couple times. So there you go, folks. I'm really happy. Kelly Clarkson to Drew Barrymore, one of these days, those two would talk among themselves and have a team show with each other. And that'd be good, that'd be wonderful. Kelly Clarkson, I kind of like her a bit. She's okay, I like her a bit. She used to be in the American Idol things and American Idol TV shows. And she had a contest to actually sing in one of those things. And Kelly Clarkson, if you're out there, I like you a lot. I only like you a lot, that's it. I don't love you, I like you a lot. I want to say that to a young woman. So all I'm saying is right now, I like what you do, Kelly Clarkson. I want to emphasize that. I like what you do on TV shows and whatever lifestyle you get into, you know. And these are big movie stars, big TV actors. So there you go, folks. I want to give kudos where kudos are due. I'm happy. I don't know about you guys out there. And Joe Biden, keep up. He's the current president of the United States at the moment. We're in the year 2021. And Joe Biden is the current president of the United States. And I'm really happy about this, just like everybody else is. You might not like him, but I do like him. Kamala Harris is the first black woman to be vice president. Yeah. And what else? Should I say any more about anything in the world? And there you go. And I'm living out my dreams. I'm living out my dreams, my so-called dreams. And I'm living out my lifestyle the way it should be. And I'm a rock star myself, by the way. I'm a rock star myself. I play a little drums. I play a little guitar. Yep. And, yeah, I could play a little drums. I could play a little, these are not kid drums, these are adult drums. So big drums with a lot of cymbals, a lot of bass drums. Yeah, I could play that if you want. But, I have musical talents. That's why I tell people, like, you have musical talents. Can you play a drum, guitar? Do you know how to play piano? Can you play a little piano? If you know a singer called Gellin, he played a little piano, a little pianist. He was good at it. He was very much good at it, I kind of admit. But anyway, everybody's influenced with any instrument you pick up to. Guitar, bass guitar, drums, flute, remember flute? A little bit of violin, maybe, a little violin. And I'll leave it at that. But I want people, we all have musical talents out there. We all could do musical talents if we know how to do it. Yeah, it's not too late. It's not too late to learn instrument. Any type of instrument you want to get into. Drumming. Drumming's very easy. I tried it. It's very easy. You just, I call it the self-taught. I was self-taught myself how to play drums. I learned very fast. I really did. The hi-hat to the bass drum and the snare drum and the cymbals to it. So I learned very fast, folks. It doesn't take a lot to know how. If you want to know how to play the drums, the recommendation I can give to a lot of people is learning out the professional ones that are out in the music industry. Like, learn how they play the drums. Just listen to the song and where the drum beats are. Yeah. And just listen very carefully. So listen very carefully to every song and where the drum beat comes in. And you can learn very fast. All you need is a big, huge drum set, and you can be on the races to learn how to play that song. And you can get good at it. So there you go, folks. I'm going to leave it at that. With some party words, I'll let you guys go. And Van Viachi. And, I hope you have a great day. And be on your merry way, everybody. Be on your merry way on this YouTube channel. And I hope everything's going to be rosy for everybody. Hope it's not doom and gloom. I don't want to see people with doom and gloom. I want to wish everybody a happy, happy year. And there'll be more coming. There'll be more videos coming up. And this is not a rant. This is not a comment sections. And I'll be listening to leaders around the world. That's include Canada. Yeah. And we want to encourage everybody out there to do what they need to do in this world. If you want to protest, you got to protest nicely. You can't be feisty about it. And what you're listening to in the background is a press conference going on. It's somewhere in Austin, Texas. I'll give you the location. I'm not going to show it to you, but you can hear in the background. It's Austin, Texas. That's where press conference going on. Anyway, I better let this go. Thank you very much, everybody. I'll see you on the next podcast. Until now,